Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Wim Oyen, and together with our president, Giovanni Morana, I have the privilege to do one of the very few official things during an International Cancer Imaging Society teaching course. And it is an important one because it's the handing over of the Gold Medal of the International Cancer Imaging Society, which is given to fellows who've contributed to the society above and beyond what is expected from every fellow to do. So this year, the recipient of the Gold Medal for the International Cancer Imaging Society is Professor Rodney Hicks. And I'm very pleased that we share a background as nuclear medicine physicians. Rod did his MD in myocardial imaging. Everybody makes mistakes in the beginning of his career and then switches to the really important stuff. He's been a professor at the University of Melbourne since 2003, and he's the director of a wonderful center in Melbourne, the Center for Molecular Imaging and Therapeutic Nuclear Medicine at the Peter MacCallum Cancer Center. Rod has published quite a lot of papers and book chapters. He's involved in numerous international journals as author, reviewer, editorial board member, and editor. And he's very well appreciated as a speaker and teacher at international meetings and symposia. And Rod travels the world, clockwise, counterclockwise, doesn't really matter. I think there are very few countries on this globe that didn't have the privilege of him visiting. There may be a few left in the to-do list, the bucket list, but his lectures are well known around the world. And if you invite Rod, there's one thing that you'd have to take care of. Make sure that the room that you have him lecture is large enough. This was taken last week when he was lecturing in the Netherlands, and people were sitting on the stairs, waiting outside, and not enough seats for all the people interested to get in. So remember, large hall, and then invite Rod. Rod does lecture at home as well. Here's a picture where he's lecturing on one of his favorite subjects, peptide receptor radionuclide therapy. And it's one of the hot and sexy items in nuclear medicine at the moment. But when you ask Rod, he always says, well, I don't know what they're talking about. I'm doing this for years. So that gives you an impression that what is routine in Melbourne is something that the world is discovering at the moment. And when he's in Melbourne, he also finds the time directing the people, and here is a picture taken where he basically lays out the land for his new department in the new Peter MacCallum Cancer Center. So he's involved at all levels. But you have to remember that even if you're famous for your publications and your lectures, it all starts and ends with the capability of building a great team. And Rod has been successful in collecting a bunch of really good and nice people, great scientists, very good doctors around him to carry forward the numerous ideas that he has and to bring them to realization. So it's not too difficult to have a lot of ideas. Like a famous Nobel Prize winner said, the best way to have a good idea is to have lots of ideas. And but to have the people around you to make that happen is what Rod succeeded in Peter Mac in Melbourne. But you don't get a gold medal for publishing and for lecturing around the world. You get your gold medal from the International Cancer Imaging Society for your contribution to ICIS. And Rod has been a fellow since 2002, almost without exception, lecturing at our annual teaching courses and continuously publishing in our journal, Cancer Imaging. He's been heavily involved in our journal as a member of the editorial board, then as section editor for nuclear medicine for more than 10 years. And in 2013, he became editor-in-chief, joint editor-in-chief. And during his work for now 6 years, the impact factor and the number of citations of the journal raised enormously. The impact factor when Rod started was 1.28, and this year it rose to 3.15. So we're getting somewhere. The attention that the journal is getting is improving. And I was talking to Rod this week, and he said, well, the number of manuscripts is improving. Unfortunately, the number of manuscripts that are not that good is also increasing. So it's a call to you all. Do send good papers to Rod. He has enough of the not so good papers. So please send your good material for publication in Cancer Imaging. So without further ado, it's my pleasure to call to the podium my dear friend and colleague, Professor Rod E. Hicks, to receive the Gold Medal 2019.
So I'd really like to thank Wim and all the fellowship of the International Cancer Imaging Society for this really humbling honour. There are so many great recipients of this in years gone by, and also so many worthy people in the audience for this award. I'd just like to pay a particular credit to the Society for bringing together in a multidisciplinary sense all the branches of imaging and the work that they've done to promote the area of cancer imaging. I think it's a fantastic society. The many years that I've spent as a member have been a joy in my life. They've taught me a lot about cancer imaging. I've had the camaraderie and the fellowship of great radiologists and nuclear medicine people, and I thank you all for coming. I'd particularly like to pay credit to, as Wim said, none of this happens without a great team, and I've had a fantastic team at the Peter MacCallum, not only my imaging colleagues, but our clinical colleagues, who are so important to a multidisciplinary approach to what we do and being patient-centred in what we do. And also like to pay credit to my family. I travel a lot. My kids love my frequent flyer points, but they also miss me when I'm away, and it's a really a great testament to their support that I've received this. Thank you very much.